Michael is playing for Violet.
Violet, let's have a conversation. I'm sure you've gotten this call, Violet. Others have probably gotten this call. Yeah, Violet, can you teach me how to use Photoshop? That's probably from your mom, your uncle, your brother, your significant other, someone who knows that you're a designer and has a copy of Photoshop, and they desperately need to know how to use it. Has that been anyone's reality? Okay, and you just kind of laugh and hang up. No. What I'm going to teach you is how to teach someone how to use Photoshop by teaching them not to use Photoshop. You're going to teach them to use Camera Raw, because that they can learn, right? Camera Raw should be thought of the essential workspace in Photoshop. In fact, I wish that would just be the way Photoshop opened for beginners. Why? There is a built-in fail-proof workflow built into the Camera Raw plugin, the dialog box. It's like a separate application. It is a separate application. It just runs inside Photoshop. Actually, you don't even need Photoshop, because if you install Bridge, you get Camera Raw too, right? So you can't go wrong. All the controls are laid out in the order that you're supposed to use them. So what's the first thing you're supposed to do? It says right here, set white balance, okay? So I'm gonna get my eyedropper tool and I'm gonna click on something that should be neutral, the cloud, or a gray or a dark, doesn't matter. Next thing, play with the exposure, get that right. Increase the contrast, recover the highlights, open up the shadows, establish your brightest point, establish your darkest point, give it a little clarity, because we could all use a little clarity and a little vibrance. There's no wrong sledding. There's no charts and graphs to memorize. There's no 10 different rays to do the same frickin' thing. It's just sliders. Use them in the order that they're laid out. Uh-huh. Stop calling me. Okay? There's a bonus tip. There's a bonus tip, because almost anything that Camera Raw has that Photoshop has as well, Camera Raw does it better. Let me show you what I mean. We're going to open up Camera Raw because you can use it as a filter now, right? And we all know how to use the clone stamp tool, the rubber stamp tool, the healing brush, you know, the 12 different ways to retouch. Here's a better way to retouch. It's in Camera Raw. This is why it's much better. The spot removal brush, all the same keyboard shortcuts, so I can use my left bracket, right bracket to make the brush smaller or larger. I'm going to go ahead and click. What do you see? A red circle and a green circle. How many of you have used the healing brush in Photoshop, clicked, and went, why the hell did it do that? Right? Because it's guessing where it should sample from, right? Here, it's guessing as well. Where it's guessing is the green circle. Where it's putting the sample is in the red circle. You can move it. You can scale it after the fact. It's non-destructive. And something that you is really powerful as well, you can also do irregular shapes. You don't just have to click. Okay? You ready for one more? Do I still have time? So that's the smart brush. Can I go one more time? I'm last. It's a bonus tip.
Bonus tip.
This is your retouching technique in Camera Raw. So in Photoshop, the reason why Photoshop is hard for a new beginner, they have to know selections, they have to know layers, they have to know layer masks, they have to know adjustment layers, they have to know how to mask an adjustment layer, they have to know smart filters and smart objects, and like there's 10 things you have to learn before you can even know what to do, right? In Camera Raw, imagine everything that you can do with levels, curves, every single adjustment possible in an adjustment layer, but on a brush instead.
Wow, right?
Okay, here we go. I want to smooth the skin, right? So I'm going to use the adjustment brush, not an adjustment layer, the adjustment brush. It's this little tool right here. Everything that you see on the right-hand side can be adjusted through a slider. So I'm going to use the clarity slider. Clarity increases contrast in the midtones if you use a positive number. Let's use a positive number. Let's increase the contrast and paint in the most important part of the portrait, the eyes, right? We've just sharpened the eyes by using a brush, right? Here's before. Here's after. You see the difference? Okay, I'm going to create a new pin. These pins, pins are non-destructive.
Hang on.
I'm going to take the clarity to negative, Okay, I'm going to paint over the skin. Okay, is it too strong? Yes, it is. But you can, after the fact, adjust the slider because it's non-destructive. Every single adjustment layer in Photoshop can be done on a brush in a non-destructive way. I'm done. Woo!